John Pearson, you had a fairly critical decision to make, didn't you, early in the new year, in January?
Yeah.
Either to stay with Charlton or come here to Leeds United. Why did you decide on the move?
In the end, I don't think it was that big a decision. I was glad to get back up to Yorkshire from Sheffield. And coming to Leeds was a dream come true, really. I was leaving Charlton, who were a first division club, but potentially I think this is obviously a lot bigger club than Charlton.
Did it help that you arrived in a rush of new players? You were one of four to be signed by Billy Bremner around that same time.
Yes, I think so. It wasn't as though one was having to settle in. There was four of us having to settle in. But it went. I think we all settled in fairly quickly. We've had some good results and things have gone quite well.
You say you settled in fairly quickly, but there was some anxiety because you're a striker, you're expected to score goals, and you went, 14 matches without scoring.
Yeah.
How did you feel during that run?
It could have been worse. I think I've got a lot of people to thank that the pressure wasn't put on me. And I didn't feel it as much as perhaps other times when I've not gone as many games without scoring. You know, say if I've only gone eight, so many games like that, I've felt more pressure. But people were really good to me. And when the goal came, that was obviously a big relief. But as I say, I've got a lot to thank other people for.
The goal, in fact, coming at Shrewsbury just a few days after your disappointing defeat. Disappointing only in the result in the FA Cup semi-final with Coventry. You played so well, of course. And then the lads had to pick themselves up for that game at Shrewsbury, and you did it.
Yes, I think that the Shrewsbury game came at a good time for us. I mean, a lot of people might have thought that he didn't. Going to Shrewsbury was obviously a hard game, but coming so soon after the semi-final, we went away. You know, the gaff said to us after the game, what do you want to do? You know, do you want to come in and we'll travel on the day to the game, or we'll go overnight? And I think we made the right decision. We went overnight, got all the lads back together again. You know, we picked ourselves up and we said, right, we're going to give it a really good goal now.
And you had to wait a little while longer for your first goal at Elland Road, which came in the match against West Brom.
Yes.
It was just a header over the line from about 3 feet, but that must have been a great moment.
Yeah, it was a great moment. I mean, like you say, it was the last game of the season, with, you know, not including the playoffs. So it was nice to get one eventually. Yeah.
Absolutely. You say you weren't put under pressure, not even by the fans, for that run of 14 games without scoring.
Oh, different class, really. You know, I think it was maybe because we were winning in those times. If the results hadn't gone so well, obviously, then they might have, you know, been looking to me to, you know, put my name in the score sheet. But things went well, so I mean, everybody says it, but I don't think it matters who scores as long as Leeds are winning.
I don't think there was any question, though, of you not playing well, because Billy Bremner bought you to do a job as the strong target man up front, and in fact that also seemed to release Ian Baird for a new role in which he's shown his ability on the ground as well.
I think that Ian Baird's shown this year what a good player he is by he was doing sort of my job before and scoring, and then he's gone and done a sort of different job which I think he enjoys more. I think it's given him a little bit more freedom now to do sort of what he feels he's best at, and he's been popping a few goals in.
Whatever the disappointment of losing that semi-final to Coventry, one thing it did prove was that this Leeds United side appears to be more than capable of holding its own against that sort of opposition.
Oh yeah, I mean, we had QPR here as well, and we proved then that we can match first division sides, and we played Coventry and everyone expecting them to have an easy game, but I mean, we gave them a fright. I think we deserved more than what we got, but we proved we can hold our own against first division sides, and we're just looking now to improve on what we've done this season.
Been a lot of memorable moments, and notably perhaps for you personally, that winning goal against Queen's Park Rangers here in the FA Cup.
Yeah, that was one of the highs of the season for me so far. It was 1-8, so it was 5 minutes to go, and it looked as though we was going for a replay on their pitch. And we just had the corner, I went up, Big John got the flick on, and it just came to me. I knew there was three players on the line, and I just wanted to head it high. And I didn't think he'd have a chance of stopping it, and luckily it went in, and it was on the fence at the far end that kept me in the ground. But I've had a couple of days since, but that's been the highlight of the season.
Yeah, we hear about people invading the pitch. You nearly invaded the terraces.
Well, I tried to invade the cup this end, but I seen the policeman coming towards me, and I thought he was going to arrest me. So I jumped down very quickly, but it wasn't anything. It was just me infused. I mean, I think his momentum of my run kept me going, and it was just a fence stop me.
That's your excuse, and you're sticking to it.
I'm sticking to that.
What about these supporters here? They have waited very, very patiently for a return of the great days, which many of them can still remember under Don Revie. But they've also had to live with a reputation, whether justified or unjustified. What's your personal experience of these supporters?
Well, to be honest, I've never seen supporters like him. I mean, we all keep saying it in the press, and you see supporters and you talk to them and you say how great they are, but I think some of them might think we're just saying it because we're actually talking to them, but they are the best supporters I've ever seen. There is a small minority who do get the club a bad name, but I think in the last 2 or 3 months, they haven't been behaving as badly as they were in the start of the season. The one black spot of the season was the game at Bradford, but I mean, the FA lifted the ban on travelling supporters and it left it all wide open for trouble, but I've never known supporters like them. They deserve success. They've had 5 years out of the First Division, and hopefully if we can get back in, we'll get the big crowds what this club can get every week, and we deserve it, and they deserve it more than anyone, really. They've been patient. They followed us in the cup run. They were tremendous at Sheffield, and they've been coming week in and week out, 20,000 plus. And we owe it to them, really, to try and give them some success, because everyone talks about the old days, the Gaffers team and all that. There can never be another team to match that sort of team. So we just hope we can win something and they'll start talking about us then.